I'm Father Ron Hoy. Thanks for sharing a part of your day with us today. This is the God Minute, Random Wednesday. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 71, Taking Refuge. In you, Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue and deliver me. Listen to me and save me.
Be my rock of refuge, my stronghold to give me safety, for you are my rock and fortress.
My God, rescue me from the hand of the wicked, from the clutches of the evil and violent. You are my hope, Lord, my trust, God from my youth.
On you I have depended since birth. From my mother's womb, you are my strength. My hope in you never wavers.
I have become a warning to many, but you are my strong refuge. My mouth shall be filled with your praise, shall sing your glory every day.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
On this random Wednesday, for this random Wednesday reflection, I found God in my cup of coffee. I know it seems like an unusual place to find God, but God's unusual that way sometimes, right? He finds us when we least expect it, in ways that might seem random. It's part of the mystery of being everywhere all the time. I love a good cup of coffee. The warmth of a mug in my hands. The smell. When I want to treat myself, I'll get an expensive, fancy coffee from Starbucks or a local coffee shop. Sometimes when we're out at dinner and I just can't stand for the evening to end, I'll order a cup of coffee after my meal just to linger a little bit longer before the bill is paid. We make a pot of coffee every morning at our house. It's how we get our day started. Well, to be honest, my husband usually makes the pot of coffee. He moves a little bit faster in the morning than me. Because of this love affair with a good cup of Joe, it's no wonder that a recent tweet on social media caught my eye. It started with, "You have a cup of coffee and someone bumps into you." I was immediately drawn in. I could picture the whole scene in a split second. Hot coffee splashed all over my hand, and a few choice words were falling from my lips. Maybe the coffee spilled on the floor or onto my slippers, or maybe I would be forced to work all day with a coffee stain right in the middle of my new white shirt. The author went on to ask, "Why did coffee spill out?" And I immediately jumped to the conclusion that someone who was not paying enough attention irresponsibly bumped into me and caused this mess. How careless some people can be, right? Well, that wasn't the right answer at all. The question wasn't who is at fault. I put the emphasis on the wrong word in the sentence. I read, "Why did coffee spill out?" Or, "Why did coffee spill out?" That's what the author intended. You see, it's really about what came out of the cup. In this story, coffee spills out because it was coffee that was in the cup. If it were water or milk or some other beverage of choice. That's what would have come out. Coffee in, coffee out. In this analogy, let's take a minute to think of ourselves as the cup. What's in your cup? What's in your heart? In this season of preparation before Christmas, do you fill yourself with things like hope, patience, understanding, kindness, generosity, so that when you bump into unexpected moments or people in your day or your week, it's goodness that spills out? Or are you filled with worry, frustration, judgment, despair? Just like that cup of coffee, whatever is in our cup or in our heart will most likely be the first to spill out. 'Tis the season for shopping and decorating and attending holiday concerts and parties. It's the time of year for gathering with family and friends and neighbors or coworkers. People are everywhere in parking lots and stores. We're likely to come in close contact with others whose cup may be filled differently than our own. Perhaps their cup may even be running low or empty. With all the hustle and bustle of this season, we're bound to bump into moments that can make a mess. Things we don't see coming our way, or obstacles that suddenly appear without warning in our path. We simply cannot avoid all of the bumps in life at this time of the year, or any other time for that matter. However, life also provides us with endless opportunities to fill and be filled. As you reach for your beverage of choice today, think about what is in the cup of you, the cup of your heart. What would you like to have inside? Consider filling up to the brim with a little extra peace and goodwill and joy so that you can be better prepared to spill a little on the people you bump into today. Remember, whatever is in will most likely be the first to pour out.
And as Jesus taught us, we pray,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord, as Christmas draws near, there are so many things to do, and I lose patience so easily. Let me not allow the trials of these days to rob my peace. Help me to see them as opportunities for greater efforts to be charitable. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May your day be blessed, my friends. Thanks for joining us. See you tomorrow.